Hey, greetings from Stockholm, from Sweden. My name is Carlos Minguez Carrasco. I'm the head curator at ArkDes, the Swedish National Centre for Architecture and Design. I'm here, right in front of the museum building, in a very, very cold but beautiful day in Stockholm. I'm here to talk to you about Kiruna. Kiruna is a city in the Arctic Circle in Sweden. Kiruna is experiencing today one of the most important urban transformation projects in recent history. The city is being relocated, is being moved by 3 kilometers due to the expansion of the mine that grows below it. The city of Kiruna was officially founded in 1900 as an industrial settlement that was built on the site of an iron ore body that proved to be very pure and very profitable. 120 years later, that industrial settlement has become the biggest underground iron ore mine in the world, exporting thousands of tons of iron per year and exporting nationally and internationally. The mine has grown so much, is extracting at such a deep level that has jeopardized the foundation of the city of Kiruna, forcing the city to be relocated.
Even though the project was started in 2004, it is today when we start to see the consequences of the relocation of the city. A third of the population needs to leave their homes. Housing blocks and heritage buildings are being demolished or moved. And an entire new city center is being built as we speak. All of this happening in a land that has been inhabited for millennia by the indigenous population of the region, the Sámi.
ArkDes, acknowledging such an important and complex project, has organized an exhibition. The exhibition is titled Kiruna Forever, and precisely deals with the relocation, trying to understand what does it mean to move a city and what are the complexities and the different angles that are at play in such a relocation. The exhibition gathers more than 100 works by artists, architects, urbanists, journalists, photographers that look at the relocation and tries to provide a historical and geographical context to the ongoing project. The exhibition goes back to the first documentations that we could find of the city of Kiruna. In the exhibition, we included a document, a drawing by Isaías Hexel, that is the result of a geological expedition that was commissioned by the Swedish Crown in 1736. And the drawing represents a mountain that is Kirunavara, the mountain where the mine is located today in Kiruna, and represents the mountain with a gray zone in the middle. That gray zone indicates that there is iron in there. So from the very first representation that we know of the Mount Kiruna, already the idea of resources, the fact that iron was there, was one of the most important aspects. And that drawing is one of the first steps done by the Swedish Crown to analyze, control, claim, exploit and urbanize the northern lands of the Scandinavian peninsula, and initiates the extractive project that led to the ongoing relocation of the city of Kiruna. In this context, the exhibition tries to respond to the big questions that such a complex project arises. What is the limit of natural resources? Until which level are we going to keep on digging? And what is the impact of that decision? And what happens to the identity of the citizens that need to leave their homes where they have been raised? But also, what is the negotiation with Sami community in relation to questions of sovereignty and land ownership? In this context, the ArkDes, and in collaboration with Kunstmuseet I Nord, the art museum in Kiruna, has commissioned to 5 architects and 5 teams to imagine, to think of alternative visions for Kiruna and for the future of the Nordic region. One of those architects is Joar Nango, who I'm thrilled to be introducing to you today. Joar is one of the few Sami that are officially graduated as an architect from a school of architecture. He works as an architect, as an artist sometimes, as a designer, as a community builder. But for me, one of the most important roles of Joar Nango's work is that he's the most important spokesperson for the understanding of what is the role of Sami architecture in today's world. Girje Gumpi is one of the long-term projects from Joar Nango, a mobile Sami architecture library with more than 200 titles addressing questions of indigeneity, questions of indigenous architecture, resistance, and decolonization. The mobile Sámi Architecture Library moves, travels to different locations, and hosts conversations, workshops, and events addressing Sámi architecture tools, materials, but also agency. For today's presentation for the world around, Joar Nango, in collaboration with ArkDes, will be presenting the digital manifestation of the Sámi Architecture Library. We are excited to launch, for the first time since Joar Nango started to work with it, a digital version, a digital face of the Sámi Architecture Library, a digital face of the Girje Gumpi. In the digital version that will be available from today online for free for everybody to check, you could find images, texts, articles, artworks, drawings, music, three-dimensional representations. And yet the project is yet another iteration of the Girje Gumpi, this time understanding the web as a place of encounter, as a place of connection, of learning, of solidarity. I believe Joar Nango's work is of utmost importance for architectural world today. His practice reminds us of the importance of the relationship with the land, with nature, but also with the resources. His practice, that is in fact a collaborative practice, is he's constantly changing and muting, like the way he collaborates with different people, is a great example of how to practice architecture today in a world in constant and radical instabilities. I'm going to leave you with Joar now that he's connecting with us from the north of Norway. If you want to know more about Kiruna Forever, please check ArkDes website, but also you can check the catalog that we published for the occasion. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm going to leave you with Joar. Joar, the screen is yours.